Half-Life Alyx. I heard a bit in the community of people saying, like, if Valve can't get this right, then VR is doomed, blah blah blah. Well, I'm happy to report that the game is awesome and VR is not doomed. Even the first chapter, where it's essentially a big old cutscene, is super cool and super fun, even though you aren't even, like, doing anything yet. It's that good. Once they break out the gravity gun, the gravity gun is such a good answer to the problem of, like, how do I intuitively grab things from places that might not be easy to grab because you're in VR, and it's a fun mechanic, and just all those little things, all those little decisions throughout the game, they do so well. It's so good. The dialogue is fantastic. It's interesting and pretty funny throughout. I've enjoyed a lot of it. The puzzles are pretty fun. The gunplay is super fun. There's not much to hate on. So really, I think this is gonna devolve into almost like a negative review, just because so much of the game is great that it's easier to talk about the few things that aren't great. And those things for me have been the shoulder storage has been pretty buggy, so I'll just try to drop something in my shoulder storage and I'll just throw it over my shoulder and I'll just be like, I didn't hear the click, so I guess that didn't work. Or I'll try to grab ammo out and I'll just have an empty hand and a bad guy running at me like, oh, I guess I'm sad right now. So that's been a little unfortunate. And I guess my other big thing would just be that during load sequences and whatnot, I still get a lot of the jumpy issue of VR, where anytime the environment moves when it shouldn't, or vice versa, where you move and the environment doesn't, it's very nauseating. But the gameplay itself is super smooth and makes it really enjoyable and immersive. I'm playing in a semi-small room, and so I'll just be super engrossed in whatever's happening in the game and then suddenly just hit my wall or ceiling or whatever and be like, oh right, I'm not actually this character. But even as far as the gameplay itself goes, it's not just a shooter, it's not just a puzzle game. And even when it comes to something like the shooting aspect, you've got your more standard, there's a bad guy, probably shoot him in the face moments, but you've also got, hey, this guy has weak points, or this guy has something you can explode next to him, or something else you can shoot to kill him, or you've got parts that are kind of Doom-esque, where you've got a flashlight, a gun, everything's dark, and things are flying at you, or how they set up different situations in general, where you have to be careful where you shoot, or you have to use your gravity gun in a certain way, or just that you can use your gravity gun in certain ways. I don't want to go into too much more detail on other ways that they do a really good job with this, because I don't want this to be much of a spoiler, but they do really, really well with creativity in general, because obviously if I'm talking up the creativity in the shooting aspect, the puzzles are obviously great, but like I mentioned, the dialogue's creative as well. It's just all around very good, which is cool to see, because you could expect a good game, but I really feel like they took it to the next level with it, which I for one really appreciate, because I was planning to do this review pretty much regardless, and the fact that I get to make it a super positive review throughout is much more fun. I don't super want to bash on games, so I appreciate them giving me nice talking points. So I guess this brings me to actually picking a number, which I would say maybe 97 out of 100. So if we're on a 10 point scale, 9.7 out of 10. Really good, really, really good. It is the kind of game where you feel like people may even get VR to play it, and I'm sure people have, kind of like I would always do for Super Smash with Nintendo back in the day. Which reminds me that I should probably play Smash sometime ever, but you know, it can hold its horses, because I think it's time to get back into Half-Life Alyx. Catch you on the next review, and there will be a gameplay video soon to follow. Enjoy.